No doubt Middlesex delighted and surprised to win that one. Keith Fletcher told me today it wasn't exactly a finish or a result he likes to be reminded about too often.
Welcome to the highlights of the opening day's play of this Ashes series between England and Australia. A series that I anticipate, and a lot of other people anticipate, will be very, very close between two very evenly matched teams. Well, the first news from Headingley this morning was that it was very cold, just as it was yesterday. There was the thought of some rain around in the afternoon, and Alan Border, when he won the toss, had no hesitation in deciding to bat. The big news, though, was that whereas England went in with six bowlers, Australia went in with only four. They've stacked the batting. Simon O'Donnell is going in at number two, the Jeff Lawson. We pick up play now in the very first over. It's the third ball. The bowler is Norman Cowans coming in from the Kirkstall Lane end, and the batsman, the left-hander, Graham Wood. And it started off nicely in this opening test match of the series with a crisp stroke behind point. Just about 10 or 12 yards inside the boundary. It's one of Graham Wood's favourite strokes, which he used to tremendous advantage in the one-day game down at Lord's, where he made 100 and a very good one.
Well, another very fine shot indeed here. The half volley on the leg stump, going down there. He picks it up just behind square and it whistles away for four again.
And he's out. LBW. Paul Allett has claimed Graham Wood, LBW. Umpire Barry Mayer is standing at the football ground end.
And you can see the wicket taking delivery again. It's the classic delivery to the left hander, pitching round about the off the middle, and just going back in towards middle. A very difficult ball to play for the left hander.
To Hilditch, who's on 13 now to face. To Hurry. Very close call indeed. Very risky run there. Alan Lamb doing great work there at cover point. Swooped on it, got the throw in quickly.
Very dicey single indeed. Hilditch playing the ball to Lamb's left. Fine bit of fielding, a little bit of hesitation between the batsmen. Unfortunately, we'll see here Mike Gatting breaks the stumps before the ball actually gets to him.
Norman Cowans, Kirkstall Lane end. It's a bad ball, and it's put away decisively for four by Hilditch. Beautiful square cut. Going in now to his second hour this morning. Short again. And again, that's Alex's worst ball of the morning. And Hilditch very, very quickly onto it. Repeated the stroke he played off Cowans.
These are luxuries England can ill afford in what generally are quite low-scoring test matches. They'll want to keep a tight rein on the Aussie batsman.
Oh, well bowled. Well, that's his delivery. He's not a genuine quick bowler, Paul Allett. He's a big, strong lad with a good action. Makes that ball move off the pitch, as we see there. Both of them to continue and Hilditch to face. That's short, that's hooked away. So the first six of the Test match, reasonably short boundary down there, and nicely picked up, beautifully timed there by Hilditch. Makes Australia past the 50 mark.
Good shot.
A very crisp player, square of the wicket, either side. Strong off his pads.
There we see the Australian captain in grim concentration, waiting to go in at the fall of the next wicket.
No third man for Graham Gooch, and it's fatal for a bowler of his pace to drop anything short outside off stump, particularly to someone as adept at cutting as Andrew Hilditch. ...50 to Andrew Hilditch. And a very good performance. He made that splendid 100 against the West Indies in Melbourne at the start of the year. He's been having a rough time so far on tour. Before today, he had made just 250 runs at 25. Made it into this first Test team and now has made a half century. Very, very good fighting performance. Vessels is concentrating solely on the luncheon interval. No heroics. Four runs. A little bit too short again. It's fatal to give Vessels a bit of room outside off stump. That's where he's very strong. But he is very patient. Brave the Yorkshire people are, but if I were out there, I think I might need an overcoat of some kind. They're sitting there quite happily in their jackets and possibly shirt sleeves. Shot. What a nice way to go into lunch for Andrew Hilditch. A glorious stroke square of the wicket on the offside, and he runs into the 60s. And in fact, Hilditch was on 61. Kepler-Vessels on 19, with the man out for 14. The total 96 for one. And a very good performance there by the Australians to get through to that total after Border had won the toss. The Englishmen, well, they wouldn't be quite as happy about their bowling. We pick up play now in the third over after lunch. Just three runs added to take it on to 99 for one. Norman Cowans is coming in and he's bowling to Andrew Hilditch.
So leg by brings three figures on the board for Australia, and they'll be very pleased with that start. 100 for one then. It's a good looking stroke. A rare half volley there, and a rare off drive too from Hilditch.
The ball's been hit in front of the wicket very rarely today, but this is a real long half volley from Norman Cowans. Not a great deal of foot movement from Hilditch, but good contact with the bat and no chance for the pursuing fieldsman.
A little bit of a sting off it, just kept the batsman down to a single. Short, and he plays that shot exceptionally well. It's four more. Quickly into position there, Andrew Hilditch. So we're going to see the off spinner. Outside the leg stump, sweep shot played, and played very well indeed. Kept down, low, and four runs. Total moves on to 127 now, 29 to Kepler-Vessels and 78 to Hilditch. This is Andrew Hilditch, formerly with New South Wales, now with South Australia. Going down the wicket, nobody out there, but a safe shot. Got the pitch of it nicely. There's nobody further, deeper than mid-wicket and mid-on. Right, of course, in the deep square leg. Well, after a very sticky start this morning, he's grown in confidence all the way along the line. This has proven to be a very fine knock from Hilditch. Two has found the gap on the offside, floated up, a bit too wide. Norman Cowns can't do anything about it, and it's four more. So the run's flowing at a fair old pace at the moment. 139 now for one. It's developing into a nice rosy situation for the captain there.
Plays that beautifully. Doesn't muck about with it. This is not the biggest cricket ground in the world, but he's played two marvellous shots around there today, both of them for six, one off both of them now, one off Cowans. Both of them, well caught. That flew very fast, and Vessels has gone. Embiri forcing Vessels to change his mind. He beat him in the flight. He was starting off to come down the track, changed his mind and went for the cut, and it flew very fast, just to Botham's left-hand side. 155 for two.
Yes, just a fraction of turn, but more than anything, a little bit of bounce. Got back to slash it, and a very fine catch indeed there by Ian Botham. He kept down and took it with his hands above his head, and really, that was a bonus catch for Jamendo.
Light is not so good at the moment. Clouds are a bit heavier over the ground. Forecast is not great. Change in the bowling. Cowans goes off after 13 overs for 51. Botham comes on to have a go at Hilditch on 99. There it is. 100 for Andrew Hilditch. What a marvellous moment for him. A century against the West Indies at the beginning of this year. And now another one here in his first test match on this tour. Magnificent effort from the Australian vice-captain. 140 balls he faced, hit two great sixes and 15 fours. Allett to come in from the football ground end. Beautiful stroke. Didn't think it was all that much over-pitched. Just leant into it and clubbed it away through mid-on.
Broader, ever powerful off his legs. That's clipped through mid-wicket for four. Another illustration there of anything which is offline has been put away by all the first four Australians. There's the short one, hooked away, comfortably, one bounce, over the ropes, four runs. Well, the umpires are finally conferring. They're offering it to the batsman. I would think they'd go off because it's only 2 or 3 minutes and 14 now. But their light meters are what they go by these days. The Yorkshire crowd a little bit disappointed, but it is in fact only about 4 minutes before the tea break.
And a very fine performance there from Andrew Hilditch, 115 not out, his second test match century. You'll never forget this one, I can tell you, at Headingley. Wood out in the first session for 14, Vessels in the second for 36, and Alan Border just starting to play well when that stoppage came for bad light. 12 minutes in all lost either side of the tea interval. The players took tea straight away. We pick up play now with one run added after the interval. Gooch has bowled a wide. Here he is now, coming in to bowl to Hilditch.
Beautiful stroke from Andrew Hilditch. Ball just a little bit overpitched. He's taken full advantage of everything loose, not just anything, but every loose ball that's come along today. He's managed to put it away.
119 not out, out of 199 for two. Border will pick up two runs there. Hilditch would look for three. And it's a small ground, even though the fielder is just 30 yards in from the boundary, he's still fairly close to the pitch. 200 up for Australia, 201 for two. Almost 61 overs gone. So the run rate is very, very good. And a shout there for caught behind, and Hilditch is given out by umpire Barry Mayer. Don't know that Gooch looked all that decisive about it. The shout came from behind the wicket. And it's now 201 for three, with Gooch striking the outswinger that moved away a little bit off the seam as well. And Hilditch out. Court Downton bowled Gooch. David Boone is the new batsman. Boone's off the mark. Ball really does race away down in front of the member stand. What a sharp drop there. John Embury, back in the English side, took the wicket of Kepler Vessels. Just only bowled four overs. The seam bowlers came back on straight away after he dismissed Vessels. He didn't have much of a chance to bowl at border. A very good stroke from Alan Border, and that's how fast the outfield is. The ball simply racing away from the fielder there, giving him no chance at all. And that was really just a nice, defensive, well-organized push. Not a bad hooker, David Boone.
Again, good shot, but I don't think he really should have been given the opportunity to play.
Bowling change now at the Kirk's Lane end. A lengthy spell there from Ian Botham. Gives way to Norman Cowans. Well, that's a beautiful stroke. It's rather pleasing. He's been trying to get that square cut away for a long, long time. And he's finally middled one. Takes his score into the 30s. Feeling that Mr. Boone is going to launch himself, but by nature he's an aggressive stroke player, and he's had a great start to this tour. I think in fact he's top of the batting averages at the moment, averaging over 100. Can't be bad form to bring to a test match. He's gone this time. Graham Gooch has fully deserved a second wicket there.
David Boone completely hooked it, hoodwinked by this one, by Gooch. Going to leave the ball and hitting him on the right knee by the looks of things. So a little bit different complexion on things now. England edging their way back in.
And he's gone, beautifully taken. Marvellous catch again there by Botham. Went very, very fast and very low. And that's a vital wicket there. Alan Border goes 229 for five. And this is a good fight back by England. Luck starting to go their way a little bit now. They found the edge. And that really was a magnificent catch.
So another batsman who's playing his first test match innings in England. Wayne Phillips, and two batsmen on naught, and England very much back on the attack.
Not a bad way to get off the mark in your first test match in England. glorious crack off the back foot, square on the offside. Few instances of that today. Mistimed shots, nearly resulting in dragging the ball on.
England will be ruining their foot. Every time this has happened, it's just evaded leg stump. And there again, Wayne Phillips is the lucky gentleman.
Counts again to Ritchie. It's a beautiful stroke. Typical of the Australian batting here today. Very quick to put away anything loose. Long half volley there. Takes Australia onto the 250 mark.
Four more. Beautiful stroke. If it's been up there or short, they've given it some hammer. They've been beaten a lot of times, but they've played some glorious strokes as well. Four more. Very strong there, Wayne Phillips. Beautiful player on the offside, square of the wicket.
Another very fine shot here again. The ball was short of the length, banged in short, just outside off stump, and Wayne Phillips really cracked it away again through the covers.
Embury has been given the ball. Good catch. Beautiful catch. David Gower in there at short point, and the ball rebounded very, very quickly, and it was on its way down. Super catch by the England captain. Phillips is gone, and that's a blow for Australia because he and Ritchie were putting on a splendid partnership. That partnership broken by John Embury there, coming on late in the day from the football ground end. But a good short innings there from Wayne Phillips, who in fact has been an opening batsman for Australia. A splendid effort by the Australians today, having won the toss and batted 284 for six. The England bowlers, they fought back magnificently towards the end. They didn't have all that much luck early on, but this is the sort of pitch where the ball is always going to go past the outside edge. Cowan's 1 for 78 and Allett 1 for 48, both of them no wickets. Gooch 2 for 57, bowled more than he'd have thought at the start of this match. And John Embry, I thought, much underused there. 6 overs, 1 maiden, 2 for 23. The run rate for the Australians today, 54.4 runs per 100, opted for having 1.